Penultimate. So it really is a shape modification where the faces have become corners, and the corners have become faces. So in many ways, this is the icosahedral dual of the dodecahedron. And I'm going to call it the dual because it's kind of the derivation of that. So this being the derivation of a dodecahedron, this will be the platonic dual of the master pentultimate. Okay, so with that said, we move across this plane here, and this plane over here. Okay, so what I'm going to do is I'm going to go over the strategy and the algorithms. Now, what I would suggest, what I'd recommend is after seeing that, is to proceed no forward and see if you can solve it yourself based upon that. But I also have a tutorial on the master pentultimate, and the solve is going to be very similar. The difference is that this, instead of having one color, has multiple colors. Okay, so one strategy, the first strategy is solving for these corners here, which is like solving for the faces of its dual, which is the master pentultimate. Okay, one thing to bear in mind is how to move these other pieces around and what algorithms we can use. So I correlated that with the algorithms of the master pentultimate. So I guess the first thing to look at is these centers over here, these pieces over here. And the way that this is going to work is, you know, line it up with one side in front of you. So one center slash, this is really the center. It's the corner of an icosahedron, but because it's the dual of the pentultimate, it's actually the face. It's a shape mod. So what this is going to do is, with this facing in front of you, go all the way to the end here. This piece is going to exchange with this, which is going to exchange with this, which is going to exchange with this. So this to here, this to here, and this to here. And what this entails is you're going to go do a middle slice. So this will meet this over here. So we're going to go up. And now to do the algorithm, we're going to be doing this motion and this motion, but we have to do it twice so that it doesn't affect these edges. So it's going to be down, 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 up, up, and then we move this back down, and we do down, down, up, 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 up. Okay, so that did a clean exchange from this to here, and this to here. Just to practice, again, we're going to go up, down, 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 up, up, and then down, 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 up, 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 up. Okay, so you can see that it did that three cycle again over here. So now you know how to move all of these pieces, and it's very much similar to the strategy of the master pentultimate. And just one more time, up, down, 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 up, up, and down, down, down. Now, I don't know how the mass producer version is going to move, how it's going to turn. This one is fantastic. Okay, so when designing these algorithms, it's really very basic in terms of the kind of movements that you can make. So this one was a way of isolating these pieces over here. To isolate these pieces, it's going to be the same thing. I'm going to have this in front of me. And what this is going to do is, this is just going to be a down, down, up, up. And where this is going to go is, actually, the way to look at it, I suppose, is in front of you, you're going to have this in front of you, this center, and this center over here. And what we're going to be shifting around is, this will come to here, this will come to here, and this will come to here. This is going to be very similar to what we saw with the master pentultimate. And also to other triangular surfaced puzzles too. So this will come here, this will come here, this will come here. Now it's going to also mess some of these up, but we don't care anymore because we know how to move them around. So this will come down. So instead of starting off with an up, let's bring this to here. So we're going to go down, and then we're going to go down, down, up, and then up, and down, up, up. Okay, so you can see a couple of things happen. Ignore these centers here, but what happened is that this piece here, one to here, this one to here, and this one to here. And note the color configuration. This this color here went here, so this sort of flipped to here. Just bear that in mind because you don't want to put them in upside down. This color here, this shifted up to here, and this shifted up to here. So whatever color you see in front of us here will end up on this face. Whatever color ends up here will end up on this face, but whatever color ends up here will end up on that face over here. So once again, we move it down, and we just do a one, down, down, up, then we go up, and then we go down, up, up. So it shifted those. Now the final one to get it back, we're going to be able to see because this purple will come over to here, this white will shift here, this pink will shift here. So once again, down, 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 up, and up, down, up, up, and it gets us back. Now, bear in mind what's actually happening is we're exchanging sides. We're actually reducing this to here. Then we're exchanging it with this here. When we go down, down, up, this exchanges over here. So where this came from is by moving this, by doing it down, down, up, down, in case you're curious. What I did is I looked here and I saw that we isolated one piece here, this. So this is the only edge that did not change, the only edge that changed, rather. Every other edge didn't change. So because of that, I figured doing a down, down, up would move this down. It'll three-cycle these edges, this got brought into here, so that when I do a middle move to bring it back up, that algorithm won't affect anything else, it only affected this when it was put into this position. So it was a form of reduction where I moved this down here, replaced it with another side here, and then moved it back up. So down, 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 up, up. All right, that makes sense. So by doing that, you saw that only this edge was affected by that commutator. So by putting another edge in, only this was going to be affected. So from that, I knew that this was going to participate because it was brought down here. It was going to be replaced by this, so this was going to participate. So it was a three-cycle between these guys over here. And what I did is I just simply did an algorithm, did a commutator, found a middle move by a piece that's isolated, moved that out by exchanging it with another piece, and then moved it back. And that's it. So there are a couple of trials and tribulations and tricks that can happen, but that's really the crux of it. So what we're going to do is we're going to go ahead, go through the process of scrambling this beast, and see how we can ease our way through this. Now the thing about this puzzle is being a derivation of another puzzle and being the dual of another puzzle, it's a marathon solve. So you're going to be hunting for pieces. It's going to be pretty straightforward, but it's going to take some time, which is a good time sink should you need it. And again, I can only hope the mass-produced version is even half as fun as moving this puzzle around, because it's really very clean solve. It's SLS 3D printed, so it has this crisp kind of a feel when it turns, but very satisfying. And Raphael's puzzles are so well made and so just professional grade. You can tell he spends a lot of time, takes a lot of pride in making playable puzzles. And I've yet to see, no matter how complex his puzzles are, any puzzles that aren't incredibly playable. Okay, what do we think? Good enough? Whatever's in Scramble now will actually start scrambling as I solve it too. But let's move these guys away from each other. Okay, so I think that's pretty good. So here it is, a very beautiful looking scrambled Astrominx, or Professor, rather Master Icosamate, depending on what direction you're coming from. And next we're going to see if we can tackle this beast.